And welcome to Tokyo, and welcome to the magnificent Tokyo Aquatic Center and the spectacular women's 10-meter platform, where we see the most tension and the most drama. China have swept all the golds in the women's program in Tokyo 2020, and they are the favorites again here. The 15-year-old world champion, Chen Yuxi, and the 14-year-old Quan Hongchan. The World and Olympic bronze medal winners are here. Bronze in Rio went to Gabriela Agundez Garcia of Mexico, and third at the World Championships was Delaney Schnell for the United States. They qualified behind the Chinese from the semi-finals. 10-meter platform always produces the highest of tension and the most drama. This is where the mistakes are magnified across the dive. The smallest of mistakes can cause the biggest of upsets or disappointments.
So we started originally with 30 divers in this 10-meter platform. They had to go through the preliminary rounds, which whittled it down to the top 18 for the semi-finals. And then after the semi-finals, we now make it to the final 12 for today's final.
Warm-up area is always very busy as we see the athletes go through their final preparations. Lots of activation, lots of final stretching, final mental preparation before they come out onto the 10-meter platform.
Yes, the all-important mental training, and that's so important these days, isn't it? The whole sports psychology, because it's not about how well you can dive. They're all good divers. It's how well they cope with it today as well, to make sure they perform at their very, very best when it counts.
Olympic medals are very rare. It's about taking the opportunity when it presents itself. Well, it's today, and it's right now here in Tokyo 2020. This is the way they line up then. We start with the 24-year-old Mexican Alejandro Orozco, and then we move through the divers until we get to the favourites, who qualified with the highest points from the semi-finals. This is where we expect the medals to go. Gabriela Gundes Garcia with a bronze from Rio. The World Championship bronze medalist from the United States, Delaney Schnell, and the two Chinese will dive last.
Yes, as you say, diving in reverse order of where they qualified in the semi-finals, but we've all seen that anything can happen with diving, and somebody that qualifies in 12th place, maybe diving first, still stands the chance of actually getting right up there, because none of the scores carry through from the semi-finals.
So we start with a clean slate at the final, and here are the athletes.
Already won a bronze in the synchro events earlier this week with Gabriela Agundez, bronze medalist from the Pan American Games. Fabulous for her to qualify at her second Olympic Games. Finished 17th 5 years ago, so has already done a lot better than that. Finalist at the recent European Championships. What a moment for the diving team from the Netherlands. Past European champion, making it into the finals. Lewis Tolson, often in the synchro events, her second Olympics, finished a fifth in the synchro 5 years ago. Got a silver at the World Cup earlier this year in synchro. The 16-year-old, fourth at the World Cup, and then took a European bronze medal. Delaney Pang, well, she won the Hearts of a Nation back in 2012 when she won a bronze medal. first female athlete in all sports from Malaysia to finish on podium. European silver medalist at her second games. Well, she finished fourth in 2012, fifth in 2016. Will it be a place on the podium today? Gabriela Ngundez took a bronze medal earlier this week. Bronze medalist also from the Youth Olympic Games back in 2018. Silver in the synchro 10-meter events with Jessica Parato, World Championship bronze in the individual. The 15-year-old world champion taking the gold at her first ever World Championships. Now the 14 years of age, she was absolutely brilliant in the semi-finals. She got tens. It's her first major international. What a lineup we have for the 10 meter women's individual platform final.
Now the drama unfolds. We wait to see what stories will be told in the next hour or so. We wait to see whose names will be written into Olympic history. Away from Delaney Schnell, she is a student in the United States, NC2A collegiate champion based in Arizona. Now the athletes will go to their positions and get themselves ready. And we've talked about how important it is, the mental preparation, and this is really where they need to zone in.
It totally is. And they'll all have a different way of coping with that pressure, won't they? Some like to listen to music, some like to talk, some like to sit on their own. As we take a look at the judges.
There, these judges, these seven judges, have an extremely important role to play in any Olympic diving competition. They can only go with what they see. And very experienced judges, they will be as fair as they can to every diver in the field, as we would expect.
Yep, so out of the seven judges, the two highest and the two lowest scores won't count. So it's just three scores that go through, times by the degree difficulty, which you will see for each dive. So you add the three scores together, times it by the degree difficulty to get to the final result. And whereas we can have a look at the dives in slow motion, the judges, they have about 1.5 seconds to actually determine and see all aspects of that dive from the moment they approach the takeoff, the flight, and the all-important entry as well. So they have an awful lot to take in 1.5 seconds. Very, very experienced.
Well, the takeoffs are an important part of the platform dive, as they are all across the diving program. But one tiny mistake at the very beginning of the dive gets magnified throughout the dive as they go down the 10 metres and accelerate to somewhere around 30 miles an hour before they hit the water.
Yeah, I mean, if you don't go in at that lovely, lovely straight entry, the ripped entry, if you topple your legs over, it can really hurt.
Well, it is painful, and there is a fear factor to overcome in training and in competition. Can rip the tendons. If you miss the dive, it can really hurt across the body. The shock of the water hitting the body also has to be taken into account. So the athletes have to overcome everything. All their fears and anxieties will be on display. They can all do the dives. The question is, can they do them today? How well can they do them on this occasion? At the highest pressure the very pinnacle of their diving careers.
And if it doesn't quite go their way, it'll be interesting to see how they cope with that pressure for the dives that come afterwards, whether they can really make it count when it needs to. We've seen a few dives in the semi-finals where, to be honest, they didn't go too well at all. They scored about 30, 35, but then they came out here for their next dive and got it right. And that's what we would want to see today if they do a dive they're not so happy with. Hopefully, all the dives will be very consistent and strong and they will get the result that they have dreamt of.
Well, consistency will be the key across the five dives. The degree of difficulty we will take you through, because the lower degree of difficulty, the dives have to be excellently executed to score the highest marks. Highest degree of difficulty on the programme is a 3.3. We're seeing a 3.0 for the first dive then for Alejandro Orozco. Sixth in Rio, she finished. Stepping forward now to dive first in the final here in Tokyo 2020. It's a forward 3.5 in a pike position. Degree of difficulty 3.0. Orozco is called to the dive. We're underway. This is the first dive in the Olympic final of the women's 10-metre platform.
Well, that will really steady the nerves. Very nice start from her there. Her final dive in the semi-finals didn't work at all, so she was lucky to stay in the 12th place to qualify. That was a lovely start from her.
Using the very edge of the diving platform, certainly filling Orozco with a little confidence to get one under the belt. You see the degree of difficulty there, 3.0, 66 scored. And now we head to Elena Wassen from Germany, the 20-year-old. What a moment for her. This is a back 2.5 somersaults, 1.5 twists in the pike position. Higher degree of difficulty, 3.2.
She was absolutely delighted to qualify for the finals. She's here competing with her sister, both in the 10 metres. Unfortunately, her sister didn't quite make it through to the finals. But that was a great result for her, the flag bearer from the Youth Olympics back in 2018. That's how much she's redeemed in diving in Germany.
Just crunching the water very slightly, which is why she was marked down a little. But the degree of difficulty will take the score high. Coach and athletes seem very pleased. This is diver number 3 from the Netherlands, 28-year-old Celine van Duyen. Inward 2.5 pike, 2.8 the degree of difficulty.
Yeah, 2.8, it needs to be really good on the execution to get the scores nice and high. A little bit heavy on the entry. Really nice tightly piked there though. Good extension in the knees, but just over-rotating a little bit and letting the heels drop over. A little bit too close to the board there as well. You need to be really careful of that because it's a maximum score of 2 if the referee deems that you are too close to the board.
Yeah, the judges don't like it when the athletes are too close. And there you can just see marked down very slightly. The degree of difficulty will not have helped. So 50.4 in third place after the first three dives. First of the two great British athletes into this final. Lois Toulson, forward 3.5 somersaults in the pike position. Exactly the same as our first diver performed.
Nice and steady start there for Lois Toulson. Plenty of support from Jane Figueredo there. She's actually coached at the City of Leeds, though, with Adam Smallwood. Right over one side of the board. That's because she does synchro and likes to That's where she's most comfortable on the board.
63 scored for Lois Toulson. We head now to the first dive for the 16-year-old British diver, Andrea Spendolini-Sirix. Same dive.
Yeah, what an amazing moment for her, though, qualifying for a final at her first Olympic Games. Slightly hiked on entry, not quite getting the legs to that vertical, hit the water, and she needed a little bit more room to get to those legs to the vertical, maybe a 12-meter diving board. Lovely extension, though. Beautiful shots in these slow motion.
58.5, the score for Spendolini Sirix, as we move to the Malaysian Pandalela Pam. Again, starting with a forward 3.5 in pike. We've seen this a couple of times. You get a chance to measure the effort of Pam against the others. Degree of difficulty, 3.0.
Oh dear. That's such a shame, because that was actually one of her very best dives in the semi-finals. When it came to the preliminaries, she had a couple of dives that were slightly off. She pulled it, really pulled it back in the semi-finals and started so well. I think she was lying fifth after her first dive, but that will really, really hurt. And it will hurt on the judges' scores as well.
Just kicking out a little bit late, which took her onto the over rotation. Judges have marked her down, and well, she's dived better than that. One of the most famous names in generations of diving from Russian Olympic Committee, Yulia Timoshinina. Forward 3.5 pike.
Yep, over rotating, letting those legs flip over just a little bit. Coached by her mum and dad, Svetlana and Vladimir. But her grandmother also competed in the Olympic Games many years ago, got a silver in 68. And her grandfather in 72 and 68 was in rowing, and mum and dad as well. They've all been in Olympics. Mum, 3 Olympic Games, dad, 2. What a family. What a sporting achievement as a family. Amazing.
Destined for sport at the highest level then. Timoshinina. As we move now to the Australian, Melissa Wu. Forward 3.5 pike. Same dive.
Yep, good start from her. All of her dives in the semi-finals were in the top 12, so she's definitely getting that consistency. And the judges really like it as well, as you can hear. 8.5s and 8s. Excellent start for Melissa Wu.
Well, that was a terrific dive from the Australian. Puts her in pole position so far, with 4 divers still to dive in the first round. We now see the 21-year-old Mexican, Gabriela Agundez. Remember, bronze medal from Rio in this event. Starting with a forward 3.5 in the pike position, degree of difficulty 3.0.
Great start from her coach, Ivan Bautista, the national coach. Must be absolutely delighted to have 2 qualify through to the finals. She knew that one day she wanted to be up on that 10 metre. She started on 3 metre, then worked her way up to 5 metre and 7 metre. But her dream was 10 metres, and here she is in an Olympic final off the 10 metre. and doing an incredible job.
Well, that was an excellent start from Agundez to open her account with a 64.50. Puts her in fourth position so far. Delaney Schnell of the United States, world bronze medal winner, back 2.5 with 1.5 twists in the pike position, opening with a degree of difficulty 3.2. She hits this, she'll rocket up the rankings.
Yep, fabulous start, really nice entry, good flight in the air, lots of fist punching. She's actually been writing a diary about her Olympic experience, and she said that her granddad predicted many years ago that she would go to an Olympics and went around telling all of his friends. He passed away in 2015, but she really feels that he's there smiling down on her because she has now made it to that Olympic Games and made it into a final.
Moved very quickly through the air, seemed to have plenty of time in the flight to make sure she ripped the entry. Delaney Schnell moves to the top of the rankings with a 76.8 scored. We have two divers left in the first round. This is the older of the two Chinese. The world champion, Chen Yuxi, forward 3.5 in a pike.
Fabulous. They are absolutely incredible. They hardly make a noise as they enter. They managed to get that alignment just right. Did make me smile when you say the older of the Chinese. One's 15, one's 14. Look at that pike position. Absolutely brilliant.
Well, the mind boggles at the skills of the Chinese in the form here of Chen Yuxi. Wonderful flexibility.
Absolutely stunning to watch, isn't it?
Perfect entry.
82.50, two nines and a 9.5 to count.
And now Quan Hongchan, 14 years of age, stepping up to the very highest level of diving and has qualified in top position for this final. Forward 3.5 pike.
Well, she got 110 for this in the semi-finals. I wonder if we're going to see any more in the final. We wondered how she'd cope with it being a final. Well, so far, she is showing an awful lot of resilience. And she has another 10. Absolutely brilliant. 9.5 and two nines to count. The 10 will be drop-off, but it just shows just how incredible that dive was.
Sensational diving from the Chinese, and they're at the top of the rankings, as we'd expect, and they're already some way in front of the rest of the field. That 10 doesn't count. 82.5 scored, and the two Chinese are locked in battle, both with 82.50 after the first of the five dives. This is where the athletes are. Behind the Chinese after one dive, Delaney Schnell of the United States, Melissa Wu with that excellent opener, 75.0. He's in fourth place.
Candelela Pang leaving herself with a lot of work to do after an almost failed dive on the first round. Let's hope she can pull it back up again.
Well, a lot of athletes going with the forward 3.5 in the pike position to open. That's a 3.0. Then they start to increase in the degree of difficulty through the rest of the programme. At least they do, those that want to win the medals. We'll see a 2.9 and a 2.8 from some of the earlier divers. And here we're back to the first of the divers, Alejandro Orozco from Mexico. This is an arm stand, back 2.5 somersault, 1.5 twists, degree of difficulty 3.2. Now you can watch the drama here, tension, everything has to be perfect. Slowly up, and now she'll settle and then go.
pretty steady on the arm stand. Then you notice the head comes forward, the knees bend to help get that momentum and push off the platform straight into the twist. Then the pike somersaults over rotated, and that's why you see such a lot of splash, not a ripped dive, unfortunately. I always hold my breath on those arm stands because that can so easily go wrong. And if they do drop down and have to restart, then there is a 2-point penalty from each judge.
.56 scored as we move to dive at number two, the German Elena Wassen, 3.0. This is the forward 3.5 pike that we've seen so many divers perform in round one.
Yep, that's one of her better dives that I've seen her do here. The coaches really liked it too. They've been very supportive, as you expect them to be. Just a slight over rotation.
63 the score. You can also see the difference between the position of the pike of the Chinese athletes and the rest of the field. Much tighter, more compact, spinning more quickly in the air. Everything just much tighter as they go through and ripping the entry. So 63 scored for Wassen. Third diver is from the Netherlands, Celine van Duyen. Back 2.5 pike, degree of difficulty 2.9.
And again, that over-rotation, as we take a chance to have another look at it. It's always hard when you're rotating backwards like this because you have to spot the ceiling rather than the water. Just slightly opened out at the wrong time to get that over-rotation, not able to hold on to that lovely vertical line that we like to see.
There you can see she's just trying to pull the feet round in midair and the toes just go over at the end. 49-3 the score from the judges, reflecting travel through the air on the back 2.5 for van Duyen. As we move now to Great Britain and Lois Toulson, reverse 2.5 in a tuck, degree of difficulty 2.8, so she needs to hit this absolutely on point.
And unfortunately, she didn't. Disappointing, but still getting plenty of support. Let's watch it again. Tight in the tuck, that was good, but just carried on rotating and then slapped the legs down on the water. I would imagine that would have hurt a little bit as well. Partner of Jack Law, who won the bronze medal in the 3 meters the other day.
Well, she would have felt the kick out just a fraction of a second too late and struggling to hold on to it going round. Judges have marked that one down for a 49.3.
Yeah, difficult, isn't it?
Sorry, 37.8, excuse me.
With a 2.8 degree difficulty, it needed to be perfect.
So Andrea Spendolini, Serie X, European bronze medal winner, inward 3.5 tuck, 3.2 the degree of difficulty. Tariff will take the score a bit higher if she does this well.
It was good. She did over-rotate again, so the heels did come over a little bit, and you saw the splash. I would have liked to have seen those feet a little bit more pointed a bit earlier as well. The extension of the feet is important. But 16 years of age in a final. She was actually the BBC Young Sportsperson of the Year in 2020, something that Tom Daley won in Great Britain 3 times, so following in his footsteps.
60.80 scored for Spendanidi Serie X. Seems happy enough with that. Pandalela Pan of Malaysia. Now back 2.5 in a pike. Degree of difficulty 2.9.
Well, after a disastrous first dive, that was absolutely fantastic. To be able to come back like that, get your head in the right place, and actually perform a dive like that after the disappointment of that first dive, all credit to her.
The judges liked it. Terrific score, 71.05. And a very tight tuck position gave her a lot of time to spot the finish as she went through the water. She's coming from a long way back, though. But personal pride, national pride at stake, as we see Yulia Timoshinina from the Russian Olympic Committee back 3.5 in a tuck. Degree of difficulty 3.3, one of the hardest dives across the programme.
Lovely extension in the legs and feet when she kicked out from that tuck. Power off the board. Tight there on the tuck position, but just kicking out at slightly the wrong time, and that's why you saw such a lot of water coming up at the end. She was having real problems in training earlier today, and in fact, she went back from the 10-metre board back down to the 5-metre board to refocus on some of the basics again. But then dived really well in the semi-finals. And hopefully we'll get it back again today.
Timoshinina scoring a 57.75 to add to the 46.5 from the first round. As we focus now on Melissa Wu from Australia. In an arm stand. Back 2.5 with 1.5 twists. 3.2 the degree of difficulty. So she'll take a moment just to balance her way up. Feet will go up slowly, making sure she's stable.
Lovely and straight in the arm stand. Her coach, Sheva Sobrino, who we can see here, has been very, very supportive of her and was really thrilled with her performance this morning. They train in New South Wales at the Institute of Sport there.
76.8 to add to the 75 from round one, and Melissa Wu is putting together a good series of dives. In the lead at the moment, with four divers still to go in this second round. First of those four would be the Mexican Gabriela Agundez. Agundez with a back 3.5 tuck. 3.3 the tariff on this one. So again, one of the most difficult dives in the programme. Putting it in early in a hope to put pressure on those that want to win a medal.
Been very impressed with both of the Mexicans. So powerful off the board. Would like to see more of a point in that tuck position. And again, a slight over rotation. Knees tucked in. They need to be within the width of the shoulders. But those feet, look at them. They really need to be pointed. Would make it look far more attractive, wouldn't it, in that tuck position?
70.95, but her first dive, 64.5, was a little lower than she may have hoped. So Agundez is just a little bit behind as we see Delaney Schnell from the United States. Lovely first dive from the American. 76.8 scored. This is now 3.2 tariff on the arm stand, back 2.5, 1.5 twists. We've seen this from two of the other divers so far. Same process.
She's always very, very quickly into her dive. She doesn't waste any time at all. And that was another beautiful dive from Delaney Schnell. She would find this quite easy because she was a level 8 gymnast before she came into diving. Trains at the University of Arizona.
So 65.60 scored. Put her into second position overall, just behind the Australian, Melissa Wu, as we come to the Chinese now. And this is Chen Yuxi, joint leader after the first round. This is an inward 3.5 tuck, degree of difficulty 3.2.
Well, the entry wasn't as good as we've seen from her. And this was one of the dives where she got 3 or 4 tens earlier. I don't think it will be today. It was good, but wasn't quite timed right to kick out those legs to get that fabulous ripped entry that we've seen from her.
So does the door open fractionally. 76.80 scored from Chen. There's still some way in front of Melissa Wu and Delaney Schnell, so there is room for these small errors as we get to enjoy now Quan Hongchan, the 14-year-old Chinese, joint leader after the first round, inward 3.5 in the tuck position, 3.2 the tariff.
Well, this is the one that scored the tens earlier, and she's done an absolutely incredible dive again. She really is incredible, just 14 years of age. Gets the somersault rotations in nice and quickly, gives herself plenty of room to get that beautiful line before entering the pool. She really is keeping the nerves at bay, isn't she, in her first major international.
It's astonishing to watch her perform.
Absolutely astonishing.
Tens across the board.
Did you expect anything less? And she doesn't even smile.
Time seems to slow down for Quan Hongchen when she dives. Look at this.
She's incredible.
7 tens to score 96.
At the age of 14.
It's
speechless.
Breathtaking.
I've never known a commentator be speechless, James.
Well, 178.50 is a colossal score for Quan, in the lead by some distance now. Chen just, well, not missing, but not quite the same result on the second dive as she might have wanted. Chen is in second place on her own, and then we have Melissa Wu and Delaney Schnell, the American. They're the top four. It's going to be very close for the bronze medal. After two rounds, Melissa Wu with the consistency. Delaney Schnell also two good dives. The second of them was perhaps not as strong as she would have hoped, and so now has to concentrate. There she is, the American, focusing on the next dive. It's all you can do. A wry smile, perhaps, at the end of the second round. So we head into round three. Alejandro Orozco, back 3.5 somersaults in a tuck position. This is the highest tariff, 3.3. And she needs the points.
She really does start right over to the side, doesn't she? Well, she needs the points, but a slight over-rotation, which the coach is just showing there as well. Already a medal at this Olympic Games with a bronze in the synchro. For that entry, you could see the hips were slightly off as well. They didn't stay square to the board. You really want to see just the side of the leg, not the back or the front of the legs when they go through that entry.
So 54.45 started with a nice confidence booster in round one, but just hasn't quite hit her dives, and it looked like a moment of hesitancy on the platform before she decided to take the dive. And the hips just weren't right from the beginning and struggled to get around the dive after that. We're on to the third dive then for Elena Vassen of Germany, back 2.5, degree of difficulty 2.9, so this needs to be perfect.
Well, it was good in the air, but it wasn't perfect. Again, not really getting that time, and let's have a look at it. Let's see how tight she is on that pike. You can see a little bit of a gap between her body and her legs. When you look at the Chinese divers, their body is touching and even their nose is on their knees as well.
It's a shame because it was well done. It was just fractionally mistimed. Now you can just see that here, all looking good. Now can she just hold it? The core just not quite holding the feet in line. ...60.90 scored. As we move to Celine van Duyen. Arm stand, back 2.5 with 1.5 twists. Degree of difficulty 3.2. Let's see how she does.
Nicely up into the arm stand. She looks pretty comfortable up there. But again, that slight over rotation. So we take another look at it, bending the legs, bending the arms to get the power off the board, but not able to keep that core strength to keep that vertical alignment. All of these divers have to choose one dive from each category. So each one of them will have to do the arm stand. They all have their favorites. They all have ones they don't like. Score of 60.80.
Well, she's improving. The first two rounds were not quite what she wanted, but this is a better dive. 60.8 scored for van Duyen. She was 11th after the second round. As we move to Lois Toulson, this is again in the arm stand position. Let's see how she chooses to go up into the balance position. Arm stand back 2.5, 1.5 twists, 3.2, the degree of difficulty. Needs this one after, well, a weaker second dive, scoring only 37.8 on that one.
Oh, that's much, much better from her. She held that arm stand beautifully, didn't she? And we saw the coaches looking on. It's really hard for them. They can do no more. They have to leave it down to their diver and hope that all of the hard work has paid off. Entry wasn't perfect, but it was better.
You can see how the arms are just not quite as tight and disciplined as we see with the better divers, but that will give her a lot of confidence. 62.4 scored. Andrea Spendolini-Siriex then is coming in for her third dive. Degree of difficulty only, oh, I say only at 2.8. Reverse 2.5 somersaults in the tuck position.
Coached by Lin Chen of Crystal Palace, giving her plenty of support there. She really has learned to control the nerves. She deals so much better with pressure now than she used to. Really nice and tight on that tuck position. Just very slightly over-rotated. But I'm sure her dad, Fred Syriex, very well known in Great Britain, a television personality, a French maitre d'. He is extremely proud of her. Understandably, 16 years of age and in an Olympic final.
...63 scored for Spendolini Syriex as we move to Pandelina Pam. Third dive. Again in the arm stand, back 2.5, 1.5 twists. 3.2. The degree of difficulty. Recovering after her first dive, which only scored 18. Great second dive. What can she do on this round?
Well, it wasn't as good as the second dive, but after only getting 18 on the first dive, she certainly hasn't gone to pieces. Good leg extension, feet coming slightly apart. Again, over-rotating and twisting those hips a tiny bit.
60.8 the score from the judges. 71 on the second round, and you can see this was just lost away a little bit through the flight. Not quite on the vertical as she went through, so 60.8 scored. And we move on to Yulia Timoshinina from the Russian Olympic Committee. Inward 3.5 in the tuck position. This has a 3.2 tariff. Or you could see the nerves.
You could, couldn't you? And that's the result, an over-rotation. Kicking those legs out, extending the legs. Slightly the wrong time. I like the fact that she immediately went into the toes being extended. But she needed to pull more forward on the front of the legs before hitting the water. She's actually the only diver that has changed her dives. One change from the semi-finals. Most have kept with the same program, but she's slightly tweaked her arm stand. Score of 44.80.
Judges marking her down across the dive right from the very beginning. Needed to be a little further away from the board and all the way through the dive, and including the entry. This is now Melissa Wu, very well placed. After the first two rounds, this is the reverse 2.5 in a tuck. Degree of difficulty 2.8.
Well, the team that are here supporting her, they really liked it. She's been very consistent today. Yep, lovely tight on the tuck. Kicking out almost the right time. Didn't quite hold the vertical.
Well, 64.4 compares rather unfavourably with her 75 and 76 from the first two rounds. And with the 2.8, she really needed that to be slightly better to challenge for the minor medals.
Lots of coaching tips from Shava Sabrino, keeping her focused.
Gabriela Agundez, third dive, inward 3.5 in the tuck, 3.2. It's a nervy dive, this one. Need to be absolutely confident.
And she was really confident. She really took her time. But you're absolutely right, a very nervy dive because they jump inwards. They start somersaulting towards the board, which makes me hold my breath as I watch it. As I say, if they are too close to the board, they are penalised, and that's for the safety of all of these divers, and rightly so.
73.6 score, the judges liked it. That's why she's a bronze medal winner from the Olympic Games in Rio 5 years ago. She was in fifth after two rounds. This may well help her move up a place or two.
She got a medal earlier in this Games.
Delaney Schnell from the United States, back 3.5 in a tuck, 3.3 the difficulty. There's no dive with a higher tariff than 3.3 in this program from any diver.
That is normally her favourite dive. It was good in the tuck. Had to almost bend those legs a little bit to try and keep that vertical line.
So 56-1 scored then for the American. In third after the first round. Sixth after the second round, but this is going to leave her dropping down a place or two.
That's a shame, isn't it, when it's your favourite dive as well.
Chen into the arm stand, back 3.5 in the tuck position. This has got a 3.3 of difficulty.
Beautiful. Sometimes you run out of words to describe just how good these Chinese divers are. Absolutely extraordinary, but I would like to see more point in those toes in that tuck position. And I think the judges probably feel the same on that. I think so, it would have been even higher had those toes been pointed.
85.8 scored. The tariff bringing that dive up because there was room for improvement. Again, opening out very early and getting time to bring the body into the vertical position on entry. And her second dive, she'll be slightly disappointed with the 76.8 she scored there. They were equal first after the first dive, the forward 3.5. And now just watch in amazement at Quan Hongchan, 14 years of age. She's doing the back 3.5 in a tuck position. Let's see what kind of nerves she brings to the platform, if any. 3.3 the tariff.
Again, another stunning dive. When they're diving, all I can hear around me is all the photographers taking all of the pictures.
Look at the height off the platform.
Unbelievable. From somebody so small, the power that she still has is just incredible. She's having an absolutely incredible finals, as she did in the semi-finals as well. We saw errors in the preliminaries, but today she is right in the zone. Fabulous diving.
Everything is so disciplined on the dive. Every element,
timing
from
was
fingers to toes.
Wasn't it?
Timing is incredible, and it's breathtaking to witness this. Three outstanding dives.
At her first major international.
Well, no doubt about who the leader is. That's our 14-year-old Quan Hongchan. Look at that result, 95.7. Two tens from the judges.
Straight away puts her coat on to keep warm. Goes out the back.
nearly 30 points in front of Chen. And then Melissa Wu in third. But it's Gabriela Agundez who's moved up into fourth now. Delaney Schnell just drifting, but still in contention for a medal here. We move to the fourth round.
Unbelievable to be nearly 30 points ahead, something like that, of the current world champion, who is diving brilliantly as well.
So just a pause, and then we get on to our fourth round of dives. This is the inward 3.5 in the tucked position. Nervy dive for Alejandra Orozco, the Mexican, 24 years of age.
Yep, lovely dive from her. Really tight in the tuck. Good timing, just letting those heels wash over just a little bit.
Judges liked it. 75.2 scored. And that's the biggest dive of the series so far for Orozco. Chinese just going through their practice routines as we focus on Elena Vassen from Germany. 20 years of age. What a moment in Tokyo 2020. Sixth after three rounds.
Another one of those over-rotations that we've seen quite a bit in this finals. Using lots of support on those wrists because she has had a number of injuries. And remember, they're hitting the water at about 30, 35 miles an hour. But that wasn't one of her best, unfortunately. Just losing it on the entry. Nice and tight on the tuck.
Just ran out of air, really, before hitting the water. So mark down for that, and there you can see the 40.0 scored. Celine van Duyn of the Netherlands. Forward 3.5 in the pike. Very popular on round one. Degree of difficulty 3.0.
I was looking earlier to find out when the Netherlands were last in a final of the 10-metre platform. I got back to 1984 and still hadn't found anybody, so it was a considerable time ago. So well done to her for getting through.
10th after three rounds, hitting a score of 60.0. And you get a feel for the way the divers are going. They're all repeating dives. We get a chance just to see the differences between each of them. Slight idiosyncrasies, strengths, as we move to Lois Toulson of Great Britain. 21 years of age, fourth dive. Inward 3.5 in the tuck, 3.2 the tariff. Needs a good score on this one. Second round was the one that hurt her.
Well, that was much better. Using the power of the legs to move away from the board. Pretty good timing, just again slightly over-rotating. So, so hard, isn't it, to actually get that timing spot on and kick the legs out, straighten the legs to get that lovely line we like to see. Overall, though, not a bad effort. 62.40.
Identical to the score from round three for Toulson. And now we move to the younger of the British pair, Spendolini Siriex. Arm stand, back 2.5 with 1.5 twists. 3.2 the tariff. She'll just take a moment to get in position.
Yeah, she needed a little bit more space as well there, didn't she, to get into that vertical line before hitting the water. But it was a good attempt. Nice stretch legs on the twists. Quite a difference in the judges' scores as well, 4.5 up to a 6. Remember, the two highest and the two lowest don't count, though.
51-2. I just wonder whether the lower scores are because she was starting to dive very low, hands a little bit further away from the edge of the board, and then letting the feet come down before starting the movement. She got round well enough. Pandalela Pang from Malaysia. We've seen this one many times now, the inward 3.5, 3.2 the tariff. She's put together two very good dives from round two and round three.
Well, this was the dive that let her down in the semi-finals. She was 15th on this with a score 57.60. Let's have a look at it again. I think the feet were slightly apart. Yes, they were, as she entered the water. Again. Feet need to be heels together and the legs straight, and then you don't get the amount of water coming up that she has. 52.80.
Yulia Timoshinina then, the 23-year-old Russian, back 2.5, 1.5 twists, and hasn't had the best series so far. Really needs this for a confidence boost.
Moved well away from the board. I do like the extension that she has in her legs and feet. Would have liked to have seen a slightly tighter pike, and she didn't quite reach that vertical line.
Very gymnastic through the air, though. Just keeping the knees
beautiful,
to keep the feet together a little bit tight around. It just crunches in the water. It's just the very end of the dives that seem to be marked down a little bit. 49.6 scored. Plenty to work on for Timoshinina as we move to Melissa Wu from Australia. Veteran across four Olympics, 6 world championships she's competed in. This is the inward 3.5.
Very nice diving, very consistent diving from her. As Andy Banks gives Chavro, her coach, the pat on the back. Wasn't the perfect entry.
Very nice through the air. The tuck position, nice and disciplined throughout the dive. 73.6 scored. She was in third after the 3 rounds of dives. So this will keep the pressure on those that fancy their chances for a medal. Coaches seem very happy with the performance of Melissa Wu. We get to Gabriela Agundez. Bronze medal from the synchro here in Tokyo 2020. Fourth dive in the arm stand, back 3.5 in the tuck. very precise, taking her time. Watch, the hands are going to go closer to the edge of the board than we saw from the British diver, Spendolini Siriex. But maybe that's just a bit of youth, a bit more experience needed for the 16-year-old, but competing in an Olympic final.
Yeah, really nicely up into the arm stand. Really bent those knees to get the power. I really want to see those feet pointed in that tug. The hips twisted just before she entered the water. And that was a shame. But yeah, very flat-footed. And as you can see, we can almost see the front of her legs. So the judges would have almost seen the back of her legs on the far side.
So perhaps half a point being docked for that across the board.
Yeah, just small amounts, but it all makes a difference between your 7.5s, 8s before and getting up into the 9s, doesn't it?
It does, and 74.2 scored. She was in fourth position as we look at Delaney Schnell, 22 years of age. The American now forward 3.5. 3.0 the tariff, so this needs to be good.
Beautiful entry. She is having a good day. She's very, very proud to be here. Says that she owes everything to her family, mum and dad, Robert and Cynthia, older sister Riley, younger brother Chase. Without them, she wouldn't be here. And I'm sure they are supporting from afar. Fabulous diving.
Well, it was just a third round that didn't quite go her way. That back 3.5. She only scored 56 on that, but she's back on a colossal score, 79.5. And you can see she's much happier with that dive. Chen. Yuxi, back 3.5 in a tuck, 3.3 the tariff.
Oh, she's been put under so much pressure from her teammate. Everybody in the Chinese team, they say they're friends first, rivals and competitors second. Get those feet pointed, and then it will be 9.5s and possibly some 10s, but needs to point those feet.
You can just see the feet not in quite the position you want. And watch on the entry as well. Watch how the feet come off position just there.
Just a little bit. Sort of the heels came apart slightly, didn't they? Aren't we being very picky, though?
Well, we are. 89.10 scored.
And so easy to see it in slow motion.
Camera really not your friend unless you're Quan Hongchan and 14 years of age and appear to be able to do anything. Colossal score after three rounds. This is the arm stand, back 2.5 with 1.5 twists, 3.2 the tariff.
At a loss as to what to say. She is so magnificent. 14 years of age, first major international. She is really holding it, mentally prepared, tens across the board. Totally incredible.
96 scored, and you just shake your head in amazement. Everything was perfect. Right from the very beginning, upright, stationary, solid off the block, high off the flight off the block as well in that arm stand position, which is extraordinarily difficult. Had plenty of time through the air, ripped the finish, perfectly vertical, toes exactly where Andrea would like them to be. 96 scored and is in the lead by a mile here.
In the lead by a mile, and Chinese women in this event have won every gold since Beijing in 2008. and look all set to keep that going.
370 after four rounds. Chen on her own. Now the battle for bronze is heating up. Pressure will be on this final dive. Melissa Wu has put the best series together so far. She's in third place on 289. 6 points in front of Gabriela Agundez. The American Delaney Schnell, with that third round dive, has perhaps put a serious dent in the medal aspirations. So we're back to the first diver on our final round of dives. After this, it's the medals. Back 2.5 with 1.5 twists in the pike. 3.2 the tariff. Alejandra Orozco, final dive. In sixth position after four dives.
And a nice dive to finish. I'm not sure if she was a little bit twisted towards the end. We'll have another look at it. But she has done some really nice dives here. Nice and tight on that pike. Oh, it was just a little bit over. But a really great day for Alejandra Orozco. And I'm sure everybody back in Guadalajara will be delighted with her performance and taking that bronze medal back in the synchro event as well from this Olympic Games.
So a very successful Tokyo 2020, finishing on a 68.8. It was just the second dive. Other than that, great series. Seems very pleased with the work she's done here. As we move to Elena Vasanen, final dive, arm stand position, back 2.5 with 1.5 twists. Let's hope she puts the fourth dive to the back of her mind, forgets about that, concentrates on what she needs to do here.
Yep, looks like she did forget about it and move on. Nice way for her to finish as she pushes those arms off the board to get the momentum.
That's a nice way to finish the series of dives for Vasanen, 20 years of age. So this will be chalked down to some wonderful experience. Six, 60.8 scored. Started very well, Vasanen, but lost in the middle and then finishing strongly again. A rueful smile, plenty to take back in the kit bag for the training and the next series of competitions as we see Celine van Duyn of the Netherlands. 10th after four rounds. This is the back 2.5 with 1.5 twists.
Again, another one that overall I've been impressed with. Thumbs up from Edwin Jongjans, who has coached her, himself a double Olympian from 88 and 92 on the 3-metre springboard. But congratulations to her for making it through to a final. Fantastic for all the people that work so hard at Netherlands diving.
Judges liked it, 67.2 scored. Best dive of the series for Van Duyn, finishing strongly. Lois Toulson for Great Britain is on the platform next, performing the same dive that we've just seen. 2.5 somersaults in the pike position. Toulson was in ninth after 4 rounds.
And a lovely way for her to finish. All the hard work that goes on at City of Leeds. For her to make it through to the final. She is a world medalist from the World Cup, but that was in the synchro events. Finished 12th at the World Championships back in 2019. So that's her world ranking.
Happy with that, 64 scored, and this is a very consistent set of dives from Toulson, except that second round, the reverse 2.5, which she just didn't quite get right. Other than that, very consistent, all around 62, 63 and 64. And now the 16-year-old Briton, Andrea Spendolini-Sirex, same dive. Seventh after 4 rounds.
Gosh, she really does control her nerves for somebody that is so young. She just goes out there and enjoys it. And really, that's what it's all about. Powerful off the board. Nice straight legs. Could have been a little bit tighter in that pike, just a little bit. But overall, some good diving.
And the judges liked it, 72 scored.
Great way to finish.
Great way to finish, and what an experience for the 16-year-olds, for the 16-year-old here in Tokyo 2020.
Big hugs from her coach, Lin Chen.
And now to Pandalela Pam of Malaysia. Missed the first dive, remember. The two dives after that, very good. Back 2.5, somersault following the 1.5 twists. We've seen this 2 or 3 times. And here we go again for Pam.
A very experienced diver, but she left herself so much to do after the first dive, just scoring 18, and didn't quite nail that entry either. Just needed a bit more room to have time to get those legs into that straight line we like to see.
So the arms barely at the maximum extension there, hitting the water at 43.2 scored.
Coached by Lee Rui, he's the national coach, also by Christian Brucker.
Well, she'll have a look, but won't really want to see what the monitor is showing on that dive.
But still smiling, that's what we like to see.
Yulia Timoshinina from the Russian Olympic Committee, arm stand, back three somersaults in the tuck position. 3.3 the degree of difficulty on this.
So this is the dive that she changed from the semi-finals. Just a slightly different dive. Could have pushed out with the legs a little bit more. Lovely extension. And a bit of an over-rotation.
So just marked down very slightly, but all smiles for Timoshinina. What more can I do? 64 scored, and that's a good finish for the Russian athlete.
She looks happy enough, doesn't she?
Oh, the pressure now on these final divers. Five dives, and these is where the medals will go. Australia's Melissa Wu in third place after four dives. Back 2.5 with 1.5 twists. Needs this to be absolutely perfect.
Oh, brilliant. Really nice dive. She's watched there by Andy Banks, Adrian Hinchcliffe and Chavra Srobrino. She is getting so much support. She's had a fourth place in the Olympics, a fifth place. The World Championship, she was fourth. She certainly has given it everything today.
Well, this could be the moment. That's good discipline around the dive from Wu. Holding on to the entry and awaiting her fate. 81.6 scored. That's a terrific dive. You could see around the pool deck that the other divers and coaches liked what they saw from Melissa Wu, and they think that will be enough for the medal.
Fabulous diving after so long. We don't know yet. We hope it is going to possibly be enough for her. But congratulations to her and her coaches as well after finishing fourth and fifth in previous Olympic Games.
So the pressure now on Mexico's Gabriela Agundez, fourth after four rounds. She's got a back 2.5 with 1.5 twist, 3.2 the degree of difficulty. We've seen this dive a number of times. She has to score very high on this to win a medal.
Well, it was good. Going to have to wait and see what the judges thought. Nerves of steel.
She needs the dive of her life.
Very slightly going over, that could make the difference.
Twisting very slightly.
Yep.
Needs around an 87 or so on this dive. She doesn't think it's enough. Nor do the judges. 75.2 scored. It's a very good dive, but it's not going to be enough to win a medal at Tokyo 2020. Wu, we see, she's winning the bronze at the moment. And Delaney Schnell's not going to catch her. And the American, who's in fifth after four rounds, I mean, this has to be an extraordinary dive to steal the medal from Melissa Wu. Delaney with the inward 3.5, 3.2 the tariff in the tuck position. Scored very heavily on dive number four. Needs this one as well.
Well, that won't be good enough, unfortunately. Just drop the legs over.
Nice flight, but just watch this. Doesn't quite hold on, and that's a shame because apart from that, it was looking good for Schnell. But really, the third round did the damage for Schnell, and that 62.4 is going to leave her in around fifth or sixth.
She looks rather disappointed, but what an experience for her. And she's done some fantastic diving, but Melissa Wu, she is guaranteed medal. Looks like it's going to be bronze. Special, special moments with her coach.
So Chen, now back to the back 2.5 somersaults in the pike with one following 1.5 twists. She's in second place.
Another fabulous entry. I felt the legs slightly came apart on the dive, but it was still absolutely beautiful. The lines that they get. No, it was good. It was very good. She's been put under so much pressure today, hasn't she?
She
has.
Her
14-year-old teammate.
Yes.
She's the current world champion. Took a gold in the synchro event last week.
Well, the standard is so incredibly high in China of diving. 91.2 scored. Well, the pressure on Quan now, but honestly, pressure? What pressure? This 14-year-old has been stunning through the competition.
She just needs to hold it for one more dive.
So the final diver is on the platform.
Lots of congratulations coming the way of Melissa Wu as we watch the final dive.
Same dive, back 2.5 in the pike position following the 1.5 twists. Well, exhibition stuff from Quan Hongchan. Remember this name, because this is an extraordinary set of dives from this young diver.
Brilliant. Absolutely fabulous diving. Incredible.
How does she do it? It's extraordinary to watch an athlete perform at this level and make no mistakes.
At the age of 14. She should be here for experience, really, shouldn't she? But she's here and winning the gold.
How many other 11, 12, 13, 14-year-old divers are there around China that we'll never get a chance to see? Because only two can come forward to an Olympic Games. And now it's smiles. They knew. Look at this.
Lovely scenes.
Except the 9.5 from one of the judges. 96 scored once again. And now the emotion comes pouring out of the Chinese diving team. And Quan has won gold. I wonder if she really knows what this means in the world of diving. Are the two divers there from China enjoying, celebrating, congratulating each other, aged 15 and 14.
What a future they have got in diving. Unbelievable. One of them a world champion, and now the 14-year-old an Olympic champion. Unbelievable.
Difficult to understand how she can do it. We're seeing the very best in the world in this final, and none is anywhere near the level of diving that we're seeing from Quan.
Stunning diving.
Keeping the hands right by the body.
And look at this pike, the tightness there. The nose reaching through to the knees. And that beautiful, beautiful extension, giving herself so much time, doesn't she?
Looking at the water, keeping her eyes on exactly where she's going to go. And every dive, ripping the dive and barely a splash. She is only slight, but nevertheless, nothing.
No. And in the preliminary, she had a few really off dives and she made a lot of splash. So it shows that it is possible. Today, she was right on her game. Every single entry was incredible.
So performing when it mattered then, focusing in on the final, and this set of dives, these five dives from Quan, the best set of dives, well, certainly in this competition. Chen seems happy enough. She'll win the silver and must be wondering who on earth Quan is that's just come and taken the Olympic gold medal, not just taken it, but dominated the event. They were level after the first dive, 82.5, remember, both Chinese athletes scoring exactly the same, but then after that, well, there was only one winner. Colossal advantage, 41 points the difference between Quan and Chen, and Melissa Wu with the bronze. And in the end, a worthy winner of the bronze medal, Melissa Wu. She was the class act among the rest of the field. Pan never really recovering from the start that she made. So it's been a thrilling set of dives. The pressure really on, the drama, the stories have unfolded, and really there only was one story. Quan Hongchan. Perfection off the platform, and a staggering sight to see. And the rest of these athletes and coaches are looking at this young diver and just wondering how on earth they can possibly compete against not just her, but against the rest of the Chinese divers who have swept the golds now in the women's competition. And, well, this is Spendolini, Serie X, 16-year-old on the family cam.
So the total score that she had was 466.20, wasn't it? I'm just having a look from... The winning total from 5 years ago in Rio was 439. That was with Ren Chen. That goes to show just how incredible the standard was from her today.
Well, Chinese diving has such a tradition, and they continue that here. Let me get a chance to see some of the highlights from this competition. The drama was set, the stage was set. It's the one everyone wants to see. This is where the mistakes get amplified. Any mistake can ruin the chances for a medal. But there were no mistakes.
No, and we had an absolute privilege of watching some incredible diving. Tens were given in the scores, quite a number of them. And Quan Hongchan taking the gold at 14 years of age.
That was round two on the inward 3.5. Now watch this one. This is another one where tens across the board. 1.5 twists followed by 2.5 somersaults. And could the standard get any higher? Watch this.
Hardly a ripple. Absolutely astounding. And so much support for her from the whole team. Taking it all in her stride.
Chen just looking on, wondering what on earth she has to do, looking at tens across the board. This was Melissa Wu then for the bronze, and this was consistent diving from the Australian.
And so fantastic to see her getting the bronze, having finished fourth and fifth in previous Olympic Games and fourth at the World Championships. She's now on that podium. Very special moments for Melissa Wu.
The fifth round was the pick of the dives from Wu. And this was Chen.
World champion. Some wonderful diving from her as well today.
And 91.2 coming in the fifth and final round of dives. And there, the perfect tens. On the final dive, and there the coach is now just beginning to, well, celebrate. And you can see the emotion, you can see the joy. It's been very tense, as the platform always is.
But lovely to see those smiles at the end.
So 466.2. Hugely impressive performance from Quan, and really raising the standard of women's platform diving now. Chen, hugely impressive, and ending up a distant second. So the Tokyo Aquatic Centre will prepare itself for the medal ceremony in a little while, and we get to reflect on what has been a staggering series of five dives from Quan Hongchan, 14 years of age. Have you ever seen anything like this?
I have never seen anything like it, and it was a privilege and an honour to be able to watch it and commentate on it today. She is absolutely sensational.
Well, a class above the rest of the world. Remember, this is the pinnacle of world diving. Tokyo 2020 brings together the best athletes in the world. And on this day, on this occasion, Quan Hongchan was breathtaking. Well, we will get a chance to relive some of the highlights from the women's platform. And I think the world is taking a breath now, looking at this and thinking, well, that's the standard we all have to aspire to. Many nations in the world or athletes in the world simply won't be able to get to that. And they're just going to be battling for minor places and places in the finals in competitions against the Chinese, and particularly when they come up against Quan in the future. She's only 14.
Yeah, the future's looking very, very bright for Chinese diving in particular, but also fantastic to see Australia on that podium as well with Melissa Wu. But yeah, the standard of the two from China was just, well, mind-boggling really, isn't it, at such a young age.
It makes you wonder if the standard of the Chinese national championships, if the Chinese were here as a nation competing in their own qualification for the Olympic Games, would any of the other athletes be on the same level competing among perhaps the top eight in China? We don't know, because we don't ever have the chance to put these competitions side by side or flood a World Championships or an Olympic Games with Chinese athletes, especially in the diving where the women are so strong.
But normally you can tell before, in an Olympic year, you look at all of the competitions in the lead up to the Olympic Games and you can tell who the favourites are going to be. Obviously anybody from China is a favourite, but there was nothing online really, was there? There's no research that we could really do because she hasn't entered anything because she's too young. So a real surprise coming out here and getting the gold.
An extraordinary set of dives brings us to the victory ceremony in the women's 10-metre platform. And it was a breathtaking performance, which we'll see Quan Hongchan, the 14-year-old from China, take gold. Her compatriot at 15 years of age, Chen, will be the silver medal winner, leading them out, Chen. And then Quan, the middle, the gold medal winner, and Melissa Wu from Australia, a 29-year-old, finally getting her moment on the rostrum. She'll be smiling underneath the mask and can barely wait to step up and receive the medal. This is a moment that will last forever in the minds of these athletes and in a career of anybody in world sport. The Olympic medals are very, very rare.
The medals will be presented by
Ling Wei Li from the IOC is leading the presentation party. IOC member from the People's Republic of China. Also in the presentation party from the world governing body, FINA, Taha Al-Kishri. Al-Kishri representing Oman are the world governing body for the sport, which is FINA. So the bronze medal for Australia. What a moment for Melissa Wu. 29 years of age. Has she had a better day in her life than this? Now she can barely contain her emotions.
I'm not surprised. Fourth in 2012, fifth 2016, and now taking that bronze medal that she has dreamt of since she came into international diving at 13 years of age.
And here she is at 29. It's been a long road, and this road has led to the bronze medal in Tokyo. Silver then is going to go for the 15-year-old Chen Yuxi. Beaten by a better diver on the day. And I wonder if she knew that coming into this event. She must know the quality that she was up against. And a wonderful set of dives herself, finishing off with a 91.2. That was the highest score across the five dives.
And took gold at the World Championships, her first World Championships in 2019, following it up with a silver at the Olympic Games, just 15 years of age. Beautiful, beautiful medals made by recycled electrical items.
Gold medal is going to go to our new Olympic champion, the 14-year-old Quan Hongchan of China. And what a moment in the life of this young athlete. And what kind of legacy is she going to write in the years to come? How many other athletes are going to come up and want to take her place? But if she dives like this, with three dives scoring tens across the board, she'll be here for some while.
Incredible achievement at her first major international.
And it was a breathtaking performance. Staggeringly high level across five dives. As every series went by, we thought it was not possible that she could maintain that level, but she did. In fact, she got better. And now we hear the national anthem for the People's Republic of China.
Thank you. Mesdames et messieurs, les médaillés olympiques.
Well, as the photographers will take their pictures, they will echo around the world. There's only one story that's echoing around the diving world today, and that is the extraordinary performance of this 14-year-old, Quan Hongchan. No one's ever seen her before. She hasn't appeared at any international competitions. Walks into the Olympic Games and puts a series of dives together that are scoring the maximum marks possible and walks off with a gold medal.
And a gold medal with nearly 40 marks ahead of the silver medal. Absolute brilliance. It was a real privilege to watch and witness this. I haven't seen diving like this. It's been absolutely incredible. Very, very exciting to watch. She seems so calm throughout it all as well. You know, we kept saying, is she going to keep this going? She's getting tens. Is she going to keep it going? And she absolutely did. And she didn't look like at any point that she was not in the right place. And yeah, tens right the way through from dive number one through to dive number five.
Not the slightest sign of any nerves. And at the 10-metre platform, the smallest of mistakes, as we know, get magnified, and sometimes it can hurt. But nothing.
Perfection in slow motion, even, wasn't it?
We saw the tension in the series of dives from some of the other competitors. We know what it means to these athletes. Winning an Olympic medal is the most difficult thing in sport. It's the very pinnacle. And here in Tokyo 2020, we saw that played out. These divers are in a different class from China. 466 points for Quan, which is colossal. Chen with 425, in its own right, a huge score. And then we have to go back down to the Australian Melissa Wu here with a 371, who put together such a good series that Gabriela Agondez from Mexico could only finish in fourth and falling away from the standard of the Australian with 358 points. Over 100 points behind the winner. Such is the standard.
And you would think a 14-year-old would be coming here for experience. But no, the 14-year-old came here and showed the world just how incredible she is. And I really look forward to continuing to follow her journey.
Well, lovely. This is lovely.
This is really nice. She was so serious throughout it all, and it's just lovely to see her now relaxing, playing, smiling under the mask. And what a moment for Melissa Wu. Yep, take the mask off for the photograph. I am so, so delighted for her. She really deserves this bronze after being the bridesmaid quite a few times and just missing out on the podium.
It's been a long international career for Melissa Wu. No better day than this one.
And she came onto the scene to the Commonwealth Games when she was just 13 and won the hearts of a nation. And I know everybody in Australia will be absolutely delighted, having followed her journey for so many years, will be so delighted to see her getting this bronze medal.
Well, we may be a few minutes before the Chinese leave, exit the scene and go to their interviews, and there are many to be done, not just here at the immediate mix zone on the poolside, but then through the mix zone in the bowels of the stadium underneath the tribune. And then they have to go to the press conference room, and then finally back to the village to recover, to eat and to reflect and enjoy on the competition and the success.
And I'm sure they absolutely won't mind at all. The interviews, the photographs, memories, those photographs to last a lifetime. And these will be donning the sports pages, without doubt. One of the big stories from these Olympic Games.
Such is the level now for the women's events in diving competition. It's very hard for the rest of the world to begin to compete against them?
Very hard indeed. You have to rely on them making a mistake, and that doesn't happen very often.
You always think it's never going to happen now.
Well, they've won all of the gold medals since 2008.
So we're going back to Athens 2004 to see anybody other than a Chinese woman on the podium in the diving events on the women's side.
Yes.
It's a run that's likely to continue. If this 14-year-old is anything to go by to judge the standard of competition.
Keeping
and Chen is only 15.
I know.
The next Olympics is only in 3 years' time. They'll still be teenagers.
Can't wait. Holding on to their flowers and their mascot. Mirror Tower, the mascot, meaning the future. And tower means eternity. And what a future these two have.
Well, we're going to get a chance in a moment just to relive some of the highlights from this women's 10-metre platform. And we will see perfection from Quan Hongchan, the 14-year-old Chinese. We will also see the dives from Chen and Melissa Wu, the Australian, who eventually would win bronze. The women's 10-metre platform concludes with the most stunning display of 10-metre diving in the form of the 14-year-old Chinese Quan Hongchan. The silver medal was to her compatriot at 15 years of age, Chen Yuxi, and then the bronze for the 29-year-old veteran who's been waiting a lifetime of competition to rise to the medal rostrum at the Olympic Games, Melissa Wu. Outstanding performances. Has diving ever seen such a high standard as it sees here in Tokyo 2020? Congratulations from everybody to Quan Hongchan. What legacy is being written now? We'll wait and see.